Good morning, my dear students. We are back with our science period. In the last video, we have discussed that rocks, when converted or break down into the very tiny particles, it forms the soil. Yes or no? We have learned in the last video that we have discussed how the formation of the soil takes place, how the soil is form. Then we have discussed the composition of the soil. What is meant by the composition? The different layers we get means actually what happens, the soil consists of different types of particles. Yes or no? That is gravel, sand, clay, mud and water. Am I right? And also it contains the humus and also microorganism, that is bacteria. Am I right? Then we have discussed the uses of the soil. Yes, soil is very important. Because of the soil, the plants can grow. Sometimes for it is the home for some animals. Am I right? It is the home for some animals. Then we get a different types of minerals through the soil. We also get the water from the soil. This all things we have discussed in the last video. In today's video, we are going to discuss the different types or the different layers formed by the soil. Different layers formed by the soil. That is called as a soil profile. That it is called as a soil profile. What is called as a soil? What is meant by the soil profile? The different layers are formed by the soil. These layers are called as a soil profile. Now, soil exactly consists of these three layers. It consists of these three layers. The first layer is topsoil. Below that, it consists of subsoil. And the last, it consists of bedrock. Now, what is the use or what constituents are there in that soil that we are going to discuss. Now, first is the topsoil. In this topsoil, the more amount of humus is found. And this topsoil is very important because from the topsoil, all the agricultural activities, that is, we have learned the different activities in the lesson number 2, that is growing the plants. Yes or no? In that we have learned what activities are done in the agriculture. The first thing is ploughing. Yes or no? For the ploughing, all the agricultural activities are performed in this topsoil. Are you getting this layer? It is very important. It contains the tiny particles of sand, clay, mud and also a humus, which is very important, which makes the soil fertile. Are you getting? So I hope you have understood about a topsoil. All the agricultural activities are performed in this layer. Then the large amount of humus is found in this topsoil. Then below that topsoil, the next layer is the subsoil. In this, the little amount of humus is present. Here, very little amount of humus is present. This soil is not too much fertile. This subsoil is not too much fertile. The roots can grow. The roots can grow deep till the subsoil. In the search of water, here in this subsoil, we can store the large amount of water. Are you getting? The subsoil is used to store the water, and the plants, mostly the roots of the plants, grow under the ground in search of water. This is the function of root. Are you getting? So till subsoil, the roots can grow. The roots can grow till this subsoil. Are you getting? As here it is a very little amount of humus. Here the soil is not too much fertile. Here the soil is not too much fertile. Are you getting? Then the below the subsoil is a bedrock. The word itself tells it is consists of rock. It consists of only rock. Bedrock consists only of rock. It is too inside the earth. It is very deeply inside the earth. Are you getting? So this is the profile or the layer of the soil. The soil consists of three layers, that is topsoil, subsoil and bedrock. I hope you have understood what is the exactly the soil profile. The layer, the different layer of the soil is called as the different layer of the soil is called as a. There are the three layers of the soil: topsoil, subsoil and bedrock. Are you getting? Here once again I will repeat all the points. Here all the agricultural activities are performed in this top soil. Here the soil is very fertile. The storage of water takes place in the subsoil, and bedrock consists of only a rock and it is very deep inside the earth. Are you getting? So this is about a soil profile. Now what we have learned, the topsoil is very important. Am I right? Here the it makes the soil fertile. Here the soil is fertile. Fertile soil helps the plants to grow. Am I right? Fertile soil helps the plants to grow. Are you getting? So if we will remove the topsoil, if we will remove the topsoil, whether the plants can grow? No, it will not grow, because here as the soil is fertile, it helps the plants to grow, because here the large amount of humus is present. As in the subsoil, there is very little amount of humus. So here on this layer, in this layer, the plant cannot grow properly. So topsoil is very important. But if we will remove the topsoil, whether the plants can grow? No. So that process, removing of the topsoil, is called as the soil erosion. It is called as a soil erosion. That process is called as a soil erosion. The removal of the topsoil is called as a soil erosion. Means what? Here in the topsoil, as the soil is fertile, if we will remove that soil, it will harm the plants. It will harm the plant. So what are the causes? By how, for what purpose, or by what are the causes through which the soil erosion takes place? Obviously due to the rain. During rainy season, if there is a plenty of water, all the soil will flow away. Am I right? Due to the wind, these are the natural, these are the natural calamities or the natural activities through which the soil erosion takes place. Through rain, wind, these are the natural calamity, natural things through which the soil erosion takes place. Now, what is exactly the soil erosion? The removal of the fertile soil or a topsoil is called as a soil erosion. Now, there are some agents. What is meant by the agent? Agent means the cause, or we can say the factors which are responsible to remove the soil. They are called agent of the soil erosion. For example, rain, wind, these are the agent through which the soil erosion takes place. Are you getting? So wind, running water, these are the examples through which the soil can get removed, which causes the soil erosion. There is also one more factor who is responsible for the soil erosion. Can you just guess which is that factor? Can you just tell me which is the one factor which is responsible for the soil erosion? Yes, we, that is human activities. The human activities, we are also the one of the factor to remove this, to remove the soil, or for the we are the one of the factors who are very one of the factors who are the responsible for soil erosion, who are the responsible for the soil erosion. So can you just tell me how the human being is responsible for the soil erosion? Just can you just tell me? Yes, see, we for our benefit, for our comfortable, we cut down the number of trees. Yes or no? We cut down the number of trees. So the cutting down of the number of trees on the large scale for our comfort, that process is called as a deforestation. That process is called as a deforestation. What is meant by the deforestation? Deforestation is nothing but a cutting down of the trees on the large scale. That process is called as a deforestation. Why? Now see, the trees are called as a soil binder. Plants are called as a soil binder. Why the name is given as a soil binder? Can you just tell me? See, as the plants will grow, the roots will grow deep into the soil. Yes or no? The roots will firmly hold the soil, which will prevent them from the soil erosion. If we will cut the number of trees, then it will be easy to remove the topsoil. It will be easy to remove the topsoil by the rain, by the wind. Are you getting? This will be helped by the natural things. Are you getting? So deforestation, if we'll cut the number of trees on the large scale, it will obviously affect the soil erosion. Are you getting? Because plants are called as a soil binder. It holds the soil very firmly, which does not cause the soil erosion. Are you getting? The first is about deforestation. Then can you just tell me which will be the next activity which will be responsible for the human being, which we are responsible for the soil erosion? The first is deforestation. The next is overgrazing. Now what is meant by the overgrazing? See, overgrazing. What is meant by the overgrazing? What happens when the human being takes some animals like cows, sheep for grazing? If we will take on the same place, the animals will eat with the root, and it will make the soil to be loosened, and as the soil will get loosened, it will obviously affect the soil erosion. Are you getting? So overgrazing is one of the factor which is responsible for the soil erosion. Are you getting? Then the next factor is plowing. Plowing causes the soil erosion. Plowing is also one of the factors which is responsible for the soil erosion. Are you getting? So I hope you have understood about the soil profile, soil erosion, causes of the soil erosion, which are the factors which are responsible for the soil erosion. Are you getting? So the in your book, the two MCQs which are given, we will just go through it. You will just take the correct answer from that. See, this contain a very little humus. Which type of the layer of the soil which contain the very little humus? Of course, subsoil. So take to the subsoil, everyone. Next, which of the following does not causes the soil erosion? Deforestation, overgrazing, or growing plant? Yes, of course, growing the plant. So take to the growing the plants. Okay, I hope everyone has done this. So today's work is that you have to draw this soil profile diagram in your science notebook. Draw this diagram twice in your science notebook. Okay, thank you.